are lemons at chew? Lemons like a big no when you're wanting a big yes, when you're closing a deal, and then all of a sudden, instead of you getting there, you see a closed door, or you've been wanting to like start a project and then comes a curtain that says you cannot. O kaya naman, you've been working out something that's so important to you, and then all of a sudden, people turn their backs, partners leave you, and all of this stuff. That's a lemon. And we all have our lemons, big or small, medium or totally gigantic. And I know that when we are faced with our lemons and our lemons stare at us as, you know, a wide-eyed green monster, we shrink, we feel bad. Some people would just say, I quit, I'm done doing this. Or they'd say, I give up. This episode is for you, just like me, who would like to turn these lemons into lemonade. Because I feel as leaders, we need to lead in difficult times. As parents, we need to lead our families in difficult times. Whatever position you're in, whether you're a leader, you're a follower, whether you think yourself as an ordinary person, you know, not many obligations, not many roles that you're still playing, you are a leader. You're a leader to yourself. You have to lead yourself out from the trouble and into opportunity. So this afternoon is just so special because I am sharing with you something that is, again, close to my heart. And I felt that every time I am thrown lemons in my life, I either make them into lemonades, or if I am more into my creative self, I make lemon pies, right? And I know you did that too. So this afternoon, let's check a bit. Let's check our profile, resiliency profile. And I'll be having some questions which are easy and self-reflective, so that we will know what is our adversity quotient, right? Previously, I've shared something about what adversity quotient is, right? And I know that this had inspired some of you. So I am coming up with a little deep conversation on adversity quotient and calling it an episode, Lemons to Lemonade. All right, you just need a pen and a paper, and I want you to help me out with these first 20 items. I'm gonna walk you through until you get your score. Our objective in this episode is to know your adversity quotient. Is it high? Is it middle? Or are we just down there? Right. Now, we can do something about your quotient, whatever score you get, all right? And we can work out something out of there so that later on, we can be resilient, or we can continue being resilient, and we can be the person who, at the end of the day, can turn all of these lemons into lemonade. All right, let's start. First scenario, you were suddenly asked to quit work or school. Either you're still in school or maybe you're not working because of a family setback. Now, my question is, to what extent can you influence your situation? Now, if your answer is there's nothing you can do about it, you cannot influence a situation, as in, not at all, you just choose the intensity among 1, 2, 3. If you feel that you can do something to influence it, you either choose, depends on the intensity, either 4 or 5. That's number one. Number two, you were unappreciated for your efforts. This happens, right? Now, to what extent can you influence this situation? Not at all. You choose either 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5 completely. And when you choose, please choose without thinking. Just choose. Go ahead. Number three, you were criticized for a big project that you just completed. Now, the consequences of this criticism or in that situation will affect all aspects of your life, 1 to 3. You choose. 4 or 5, it will just be limited to that situation. Mm-hmm. Number 4, you accidentally deleted a very important email. All right. The consequences of this situation will 1 to 3 if it will last forever. 4 or 5, it will quickly pass. Okay, I hope you're keeping score. Number 5, the high priority project you are working on gets canceled. Now, the consequences of this situation will affect all aspects of your life. Choose 1 to 3, depends on the degree. 4 or 5, it will just be limited to the situation. Number 6, someone you respect ignores your attempt to discuss an important issue. Now, to what extent do you feel responsible for improving the situation? Not responsible at all, 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5, completely responsible. Number 7, people respond unfavorably to your latest ideas. They just said, no way, that's not gonna work. Now, to what extent can you influence a situation? If you say not at all, choose either 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5, completely. Number 8, you were unable to take your much needed vacation. The consequences of this situation will last forever. 1, 2, 3, that's your choices. 4, or 5, it will quickly pass. 9, you hit every red light on your way to an important appointment. Now, the consequences of this situation will affect all aspects of your life. 1, 2, 3, that's your choice. 4, or 5, it will just be limited again to that situation. 10, after extensively searching, you cannot still find an important document. All right? Or maybe after waiting too long, you cannot still find Mr. True Love or Miss True Love, however your situation is. Now, the consequences of this situation will last forever. 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5, it will quickly pass. All right. Number 11, your friends start to walk out on you. Ouch. Right? Now, to what extent do you feel responsible for improving this situation? If you think you're not responsible at all, then you choose 1, 2, 3. But if you feel you are completely responsible, choose 4 or 5. 12, you miss an important appointment. The consequences of this situation will affect all aspects of your life. 1, 2, 3, those will be your choices. 4 or 5, it will completely be limited to the situation. 13, your personal and work obligations are out of balance. Now, to what extent can you influence a situation? Not at all right? Not at all. You'd say 1, 2, 3. Completely, you say 4 and 5 or 5. Number 14, you never seem to have enough money. Now, the consequences of this situation will last forever. 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5, it will quickly pass. 15, you failed to pass an important test to advance your profession. All right, now, to what extent will this situation affect you? If you say not at all, 1, 2, 3 will be your choices. 4, or 5, completely. 16, now you lost an important client due to service complaints. This happens. Now, to what extent will you feel responsible for this? Not at all, you're not responsible at all. You choose 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5, completely responsible. 17, your computer crashed for the 3rd time this week. Ah, too bad. Now, to what extent can you influence your situation? You say not at all, 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5, completely. 18, the meeting you are in is a total waste of time. Now, to what extent do you feel responsible in improving the situation? Not responsible at all, 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5, completely. 19, we're almost there. You lost something or someone important to you. All right. The consequences of this will last forever. 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5, it will go quickly pass. Okay. 20, your colleagues adamantly disagree with your decision. Now, the consequences of this situation will affect all aspects of your life. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, it will just be again limited to that situation. So these are your 20 questions. Now, how do you score? All right. I want you to write C-O-R-E. C stands for control, which I've been discussing in the previous episodes. O stands for ownership. R stands for reach. And E stands for endurance. So all the items under C would be numbers 1, 7, 13, 15, 17. All the items under ownership or letter O will be items 2, 6, 11, 16, 18. And all the items under reach will be items or numbers 3, 5, 9, 12, 20. And endurance will be 4, 8, 10, 14, 19. Now, lump it up. I'm going to give you time, right? You can always, push that kind of thug button to go back to all of this. But just for the interest of time, I'm going to move forward and say, this is how you'd go forward in your scoring. Add total C plus O plus R plus E, right? So you total that. Now you get your score, multiply it by 2. So you would get your adversity quotient score. Now, you would either get these numbers, 178 to 200. If you belong to that range, that means, congratulations, you have a high adversity quotient. If you score 161 to 177, that means you have moderately high AQ, not bad at all. If you score 135 to 160, moderate adversity quotient. 118 to 134, moderate below. And 117 below, that means you have a low adversity quotient. Now, do not be discouraged if you get anything below 160. Take note. This is a snapshot. This is not a portrait of who you are. This can change. Your scores will change. Maybe after, embracing growth mindset and learning more about yourself, learning more about your core, your control, your ownership, your reach, and your endurance, or maybe having a better mindset about things, how you influence and respond things, this will change. Because again, as I said, this is never a portrait. This is a moving snapshot. It will definitely change. Nagbabago po ito. All right, now, so what is so good about this? Now, why do we have to aspire to have a high adversity quotient? Okay? Una sa lahat, kailangan nating magkaroon ng mataas na adversity quotient, and we should be helping ourselves get there, because ang mga taong may mataas na adversity quotient, they have the resilient spirit. These are the people who can turn lemons to lemonade at the end of the day, who can see a no as an opportunity for more yeses in the future. Now, I have, a quick items here to help you strengthen your core, your control, your ownership, your reach, and your endurance. So that you can join the community of people who are lifting other people up, and those who can lift are people with high adversity quotient, right? People who do not shout at the middle of a stressful situation. People who cannot be overwhelmed despite the stresses that surround them. People who can smile through the storm. People who can close their eyes peacefully and calmly, even if there's like lightning and thunder in their lives, right? These people would definitely be inspiring. Why? Because they have one thing that will make them one. That is resiliency in spirit. That is adversity quotient. All right. So number one, you have to be a detective. What does that mean? If you are, because we have to think scientifically as well. If we cannot just say, I have an AQ and that's it. I have a high adversity quotient and that's it. We have to make sure that we also have an evidence for saying that, at least in our lives. All right. So be a detective. You have to point out the cause. What is the reason for things? You have to be a lawyer. Right, you have to prove your case with the real evidence. It's very, very important. We have to be a judge, right? And what's a very good attribute of a judge, you only issue judgment based on facts, not emotions. Emotions will overwhelm us if these are uneducated emotions. Now, we also have to be a pioneer. You lead ownership into difficult situations. If we're confronted by a certain issue, instead of us being defensive, then we have to be accepting and we have to lead ourselves through the difficult situation, right? Being defensive doesn't get us anywhere, all right? Be a firefighter. We contain the blaze and then host down emotions. Huwag gatong na emosyon. Ang ginagatungan mo pa yung emosyon mo, no? Dinadagdagan mo pa ng drama sa isip mo yung sitwasyon mo. That will change. I remember reading a wonderful analogy of two old men facing a beach, right? They were both in a nursing home, all right? Okay, and then they were both seated on their wheelchair. The first old man asked the second, sabi niya, bakit ka nandito sa home care? Ang sagot nung pangalawang kasama niya, sabi niya, dahil mahal ako ng mga anak ko, mahal ako ng pamilya ko, they wanted the best care for me, and in the home care, nandito yon. They come visit me and I'm happy, and I have everything I need. I have the beach, I have this, I have all the amenities I need. How about you? Sagot naman nung nagtanong, sabi niya, well, I am in a desolate situation. Walang nagmamahal sa akin, kaya tinapon na lang ako dito sa home care na to. I feel bad. I ended up this way, etc., etc. See, they have the same situation, right? Exactly the same situation. Pero anong pagkakaiba nila? Mindset nila sa perspective na nangyayari sa kanila. Someone is flaming up the emotion, right? The other one is trying to hose down the emotion, and alam niya kung paano i-control yung kanyang mga pag-iisip na hindi makakatulong sa kanyang health and well-being, right? Okay. Be an opportunist. Pick up just the good ones. Be a surgeon. You prevent the bleeding surgically and dump the damage. Be a visionary. Look beyond today. Hindi natatapos ang buhay ngayong araw at oras na to. Look beyond today. Be an accountant. You create a balance sheet of the good or bad, right? Asset and liability. So, wala, hindi lahat asset, hindi lahat liability sa buhay. Hindi lahat sa tao masama. Hindi lahat naman sa tao maganda. Just balance it. Alright? And the last one is, let us all become a catalyst. Say the word with me. Catalyst. Type it there. Catalyst. Okay. And that means that take even the smallest clue of success to start again. Happy weekend, everyone. I wish you all wonderful times of making your lemons into lemonades, because there is no other way. People are hoping to see us stronger. We have responsibilities on our shoulders. We have our family trusting that we will make it through for them. So we have to keep that strength. We have to finish strong. We have to turn all these lemons into lemonades. So we can all say, it's a beautiful life. Love had saved our day. I'd like to remind you before I say goodbye, I'd like to remind you again, we're running a wonderful program. Please check this out. It's called Emotional Reset, Turning Your Emotions into Guidance and Power. You can visit our website at www.brycecaries.com to know more about it. And also, please, we're growing our tribe. Allow us to be part of your learning platform and learning time. Go to YouTube and please look for Usapang B, click the like, and subscribe, click the like, and then the bell so that you can be notified. And for the Facebook also, please follow us and share. Tell others that you are with us here at Usapang B so that it's gonna be a happy world after all. Thank you so much, everyone. Let love save the day. My name is Bryce, and I am your friend here at Usapang B. Bye!